Students, whatever homework is given to you, you have to submit it on the very next day between 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. to the given WhatsApp number, and it is compulsory to submit your homework as your attendance will be marked on the basis of your submission.
Probability chapter. Is it right? What's probability? So last year also you learned the probability, that was experimental probability, yeah, empirical probability. This year we are going to give a theoretical approach to that probability, that is theoretical probability. All things I explained, let us summarize in a short. That means probability of an event, number of outcomes favorable to that event and divided by number of possible outcomes in that event. Here we are considering about equally likely outcomes only for this type of events. That means equally likely outcomes also I have told you that. What was equally likely outcomes are not equally likely outcomes in the case of tossing of a coin and tossing of a die. Is it right? And not equally likely outcome also we have discussed. There is no need to explain again and again. And we have discussed about elementary events. Possible outcome of the experiment is 1. Then we will call that, that means number of favorable outcomes is 1 for that particular event is called an elementary event. And then we have learned about impossible event. Impossible event means it is not at all possible. That type of events, what is the probability? That means probability of that event is always is equal to 0. Then you have discussed about sure or certain event. That means completely that possibility is there. Sure event. That means, for example, sun rises in the east. 1 is a natural number. These all are possible event, that means sure events. Therefore, we can say that that type of events, the probability of that particular event is equal to 1. And here, impossible event, P of E equal to 0. So here you can see that whenever a probability of an event is taken, so you can say that it will be always in between 0 and 1 only. 0 is also possible, 1 is also possible, and between whatever the numbers are coming, that will be coming for the probability of an event. That means probability of event will be is equal to 0 less than or equal to probability of event less than or equal to 1. That means probability of event should not be greater than 1 and should not be less than 0. That means minus value is not possible and more than 1 is also not possible, but up to 0 and up to 1 it is possible for a particular event. Now this all we have already explained. This is the only one thing I want to explain today. That means always probability of that event will be is equal to 0 less than or equal to probability of event less than or equal to 1. Okay, now let us do some of the examples and the sums related to that in the exercise. Okay, now let us question number, example number 4 in your textbook. Say question is given that one card is drawn from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards. Calculate the probability that the card will be an ace and not be an ace. So here first of all you should understand the deck of cards, what are the various categories in that. You know better than me, I think I know that. Then also, I'll explain. Those who don't know, I'll explain that. In the deck of a card, total number of cards is how much? 52. And that means 52 means 4 suits of 13 cards. So 4 into 13, it is equal to 52. Now, 4 suits means which are the 4 suits? So, one is spade, other one is hot, then diamond and club. Okay, these are the 4 types of cards. And symbols also you are knowing that spade, hot, diamond, club. Symbol also I have marked here. And hot and diamond are in which color? Red color. And spade and club are in a black color. Now here 4 suits. So you got that which are the 4 suits. Now 13 cards means in each suits which are the 13 cards? Ace is there, king is there, queen is there, jack is there. The numbers, which are they? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3 and 2. Total 13 cards. And here, King, Queen and Jan will be of the name is given that face card. Now understood children clearly? This is very important question because card type, card sum, it is going to be asked in the examination for the probability. So look at that. Now the question you just revise it. What was the question? 50 cards. What is the probability that the card will be an ace? So let us look that. Ace is for each suit. Is it right? In first suit also one ace will be there. Here also one will be there. Here also will be there. Here also will be there. Then how many aces will be there? 4 aces will be there. That means the number of outcomes favorable to that event. That means ace is 4. Out of how many events, total number of events are that? That is equal to total number of outcomes. Possible outcomes are that 52. Therefore, what will be the answer for that? So you will write that the number of outcomes favorable to that event. Number of outcomes favorable. That you should write in the numerator. Favorable to this event. Which is that event we are considering? The event is equal to the card is an ace. That is our A. Card is an ace. That is our event. Now, what is the number of favorable outcomes favorable to this event? It is equal to 4. Our total number of outcomes, that will be is equal to how much? 52. Now, probability of that event will be is equal to what will that? 4 by 52. You can cancel it and you can write that 1 by 30. Now, clear for you children? Therefore, total ace in this deck of card will be is equal to 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Total is 4. The number of outcomes favorable to this event is equal to 4. And out of that, total number of outcomes is equal to possible outcomes. Total number. It is equal to 52. Therefore, answer will be 4 by 52 is equal to 1 by 30. Now, one more question is there that. What is the question that? It is not an ace. Do you know that these 4 cards you are removing? That all cards will be not an ace. Because ace cards will be only 4. The remaining, how many cards will be remaining? It will be 48. Why? Because 52 minus 4. So it will be 48. So that case, sir, what will be the answer for this? So you can say that there also the card is not an ace. You will write that now the event is that card is not an ace. Now number of outcomes favorable. How much will be the number of outcomes favorable is equal to, you can write that 52 minus 4 is equal to 48. That means probability of that event is equal to 48 by 52. Okay, what is children? 48 by 52. This one you can simplify and write that is equal to 12 by 30. Now look at these two questions. First question was card was an ace. Second question was card is not an ace. I already mentioned to you that these two are complementary events. One is an ace, other one is not an ace. So how can you find out in another way also? You can find out this answer 12 by 30. How will you find out? We have already learned that P of E plus P of E bar is equal to how much? 1. For card is an ace, we will keep it as E and E bar. That means not E. You will write that the card is not an ace. Because these both are complementary events. Now already you have seen that P of E plus P of E bar is equal to 1. P of E already you have find out that it will be is equal to 4 by 52. Yeah, that will be is equal to 1 by 13. Plus P of E bar is equal to 1. And this way also you can find out that 1 minus 1 by 13. Clear for you children? That means these both events are complementary events. When you are summing up, you are going to get it as 1. So if you find out this answer, probability of this event, that means card is an ace. So you can find out the probability of the card is not an ace by subtracting 1 upon 13 from 1. You will get that answer of this, the question, the probability that the card is not an ace. So what will be coming here? 12 by 13. The same answer you have got before also. How much was that? 48 by 52. There also you got the answer as 12 by 13. So this type of card sums are very important for you that you have to learn it by heart. First of all, you should have an idea about that. How many cards are there? What are the various cards and how many types of cards are there in that? You know, then also I am again explaining this one. Okay, now next question we can see. Now, let us look another example. That is also an important sum that is about dice. Do you know that you are also playing in the snake and ladder, that dice, using the dice you are playing? So here, the question is that, example number 13. What was that question? Two dice, okay? One is blue and one is gray are thrown at the same time. You know that if one die is throwing, you are tossing, you are going to get the number of possible outcomes 6. Either it can come 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now, if two dice are thrown at the same time, so how many possible outcomes can come for that? And out of that, you have to find out that the sum of two numbers appearing on the top of the dice, means top of the dice two numbers will come, that numbers is, sum of the numbers is 8. That is the first question. Second question, sum of the two numbers, how it is going to come 13. Then third probability, you have to find out that sum of the two numbers less than or equal to 12. Three questions are there. So first you have to see that what are the possible outcomes when two dice, one is blue and another one is gray, that both dice are thrown at the same time. The number of possible outcomes, how it will be 36. Because you know that if the blue die shows 1, so it can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this die can be, that means 1, 1 will be one possibility. Second one, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. Suppose this die, if it has shown 2 here, so remaining the other gray dice can show 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. Now 3, if blue die shows 3, so gray die can show 1, gray die, top of the gray die can show 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. So here total outcomes, if you are considering, how many possible outcomes can come, means this each pair you can consider as 1. So how many total pairs will be there here? Here 6 and here 6. That means total 6 are 36 possible outcomes will be favorable to this event. Now the question with them is total number of possible outcomes, not favorable. Total number of outcomes, possible outcome is how much is that? 36. Now let us look at the question. First question, what was asked? The sum of the two numbers which is coming on the two dice is equal to 8. So you are supposing that the event is equal to sum of two numbers. Sum of two numbers appearing on the top of the die. Is equal to 8. So which are the possibilities here? You know that if you are considering here in any case 1 plus 1, 2, 1 plus 2, 3, 1 plus 3, you are not going to get 8. But in this case, you can say that 2 and 6, if it is coming, the 2 plus 6 is coming as 8. Now, this pair if you are considering, you know that 3 and 5, when you are totaling, you are going to get 8. Then next line if you are looking, 4, 4, 4 plus 4, 8. Next line, 5 plus 3, 8. Next line, 6 plus 2, 8. So how many outcomes are there favorable to this particular event? What is that event? Sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of the dice is equal to 8. Which are the favorable outcomes? 2, 6, 3, 5, 4, 4, 5, 3 and 6, 2. That means how many outcomes are coming here? The number of outcomes favorable? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So how will you write the probability of that event is equal to 5 upon number of possible outcomes, already you have written that. 5 by 36. Now you may clear that this type of questions it is going to be asked in the examination. So please be careful about this one. Means here for 36 outcomes are there. In one dice, if it is thrown, so only 6 possibilities are there. That means number of possible outcomes are 6. But 2 are thrown at the same time, the total number of possible outcomes are 36. Now one question only you have solved. The second question is that sum of the two numbers on the dice, that means both the dice top numbers, if you are plusing, that means summing, so you are getting it as 13. Is it possible? Because the pair, if you are taking last pair 6 6, so there you are going to get 6 plus 6 12 only, not 13. That means that is an important event for this. That means impossible event for this. That means that possibility is not at all present here. What will you write that case? You will say that is an impossible event, therefore it will be equal to 0. Why? Because sum of the numbers is 13. Two numbers is equal to 13 is asked. Two numbers on the top of the dice is equal to 13. That is never possible. That means you will say that it is an impossible event. You will say that is equal to 0. Now one more question is that less than or equal to 12. Less than or equal to 12. So look at here. These all the numbers, if you are plusing, ordered pairs numbers you are plusing, you are going to get less than 12 only, because 1 plus 1, 2, 1 plus 2, 3, 1 plus 3, 4, 1 plus 4. Like that, if you are considering this all, last number will be 6 and 6. 6 plus 6, that is also 12. That means less than or equal to 12. All these outcomes are coming. That means 36 outcomes will come for that, favorable to that particular event. That case, what if you say that the event probability of that event will be is equal to 36 by 36. Why it is 36 by 36? Because all the outcomes, if you are favorable, outcomes are favorable to that particular event. What was that event? The event is equal to sum of two numbers on the die is less than or equal to 12. So all the ordered pairs will satisfy that particular event. Therefore, number of possible outcome will be 36 and total number of outcomes also will be 36. Therefore, answer will be is equal to 1. That means it is a sure event, certain event. That means P of E is equal to 1. So here three cases you have seen. One is impossible event, other one is certain event, and another one you have find out that sum of the two numbers on the dice is equal to 8. But always it is not asking that always dice is 8 only. You look at the exercise exam, exercise one question is there, continuation of this one. That means exercise 15.1, question number 22. There one table is asked. That table, you can see in that, check that table. There it is asked, sum of the event on the two dice is 2. Sum of the events on two dice is 3. Sum of the numbers on the two dice is equal to 4. Like there will be a question is there. So this way you have to make that chart and then you have to find out that what is the probability of that. If the sum of the events appearing on the top of the dice is equal to 2. How it will be 1 plus 1, 2, that means you will get only one chance. One outcome favorable, that means 1 by 36. If it is 3, sum of the numbers which are on the both the dice is 3. Which are the outcomes come? 1, 2 can come, 2, 1 can come. No other numbers will be there. That means here how many outcomes you will get? 2 upon 36. If it is 4, like that way, 2, 3 and 4. 4 over the 4, how it will be? 1 plus 3, 4 and 2 plus 2, 4. That means 2 or 3, 1 plus 3 and 3, 1. This one also. 1, 3, 2, 2 and 3, 1. That means how many outcomes will be favorable? 3 outcomes, 3 upon 36. Then you can do yourself in your textbook. Just you complete that one. That sum you can complete yourself.